So today we're going to be simulating audio movement, I guess would be the best title for this. Essentially what we're going to do is take a piece of audio and just move it around the screen and then render the contents and then use that to make our results a little bit better. So I'm just going to set up a quick example to show you what I mean. I'm just going to add an image. This is a very simple image of a radio just to kind of visualize what I'm talking about. So let's say you've modeled this radio here and then you want to animate the camera. So I would press I to add a keyframe, location, go to the end frame, move this closer, I to add a keyframe, location. We jump to the camera view now and we see it does this. If you've got a simple animation like this and you add in the audio in post, you'd probably just increase the volumes. Same thing if the camera is moving left and right. You know, you just sort of animate the or fade the volume from left to right. But an easy way to do it is just simply adding in a speaker. Shift A, go down to speaker, which is essentially going to add in our audio for us, so it will match the movement of the scene as well. And if we click the speaker, we go over here to the speaker tab, we can just add the audio and we can actually leave the settings as they are. But this is a very simple example. I'm going to show you another example, so let's just get rid of this. Let's say you want to simulate the audio for a movie clip. Now this is just a standard movie clip. I've done nothing to this video, but we have the audio for the cars, but we don't have any audio for the sirens. So what I'm going to do is simulate the audio of a siren and make it approach the camera and then go beyond, so go behind us. And then I'm going to render the audio file and then just add it to this movie clip in post. So jump back to the 3D view. And the way I'm going to do this is just jump to the camera view by pressing number pad 0. Then I'm going to press N, and what we want to do is activate background images, add image, and then we actually want to change this to movie clip. If we uncheck camera clip, then we can select the movie clip. So let's jump back to the first frame. So I'm going to go ahead and add in the speaker, Shift A, all the way down to speaker. Now first we can see the speaker's not really pointed at the camera, so let's just press R to rotate, then press X, 90. It's facing the opposite direction, so before we do anything else, if we press minus, then it'll just flip it. There we go. I'm going to split this window, so I'm going to get two angles. I'm going to press numpad 0 over here. This is going to preview what the camera will see. And this one is just going to give me an idea how far away from the camera it should be to give me a guess. But what I'm going to do is just bring this back all the way over here. And just leave it there. So it's quite far out. That's going to be our start position. If I press I to add a keyframe and press location, I'm going to move this all the way forward. So now we can see when it gets to about here, we need this to be at least right near the camera, so I'll grab it over there and then just bring it down. If you want, you can press I to add a keyframe, location. Let's go to the end frame. Let's just drag this all the way back. Press I to add a keyframe, location, and there you go. Split this window, change this to the graph editor. Since we've got all these already selected, if we press V, we can just turn this into a vector. So now it should just move from A to B without speeding up and slowing down. Now we need to go ahead and open up the sound, which is pretty simple. So the audio I'm using, I picked up from YouTube. It's one of the free sound effects that they've got. But again, you can use any sound effects that you want. If anybody knows a good site to find sound effects, leave it in the comments below. It's always great to find free assets. This is the, there's a few settings we can change. Essentially, most of these settings you won't need to use. It works as standard, but if you do need to play around with these settings, go ahead and do that. So once you're happy with this, you want to go ahead and jump to the first frame. Let's go to the render panel. Go ahead and hit audio. So let's first set where we're going to save this to. And then it's going to give you a couple of options here. The container. This is going to be what kind of container you want to save this to. So depending on what kind of program you use and what file type you want to use, go ahead and use that. You can use any of these that you want to. I'm going to go ahead and use this as a WAV. Format, I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure what any of these do. Again, someone in the comments will probably let me know, but for me, I'm just going to leave it at S16 and it seems to work fine. Same thing for the accuracy, I'm going to leave this as well. But once you're happy with the container, let's go ahead and name this. It's going to be Siren. And then go ahead and hit Mixdown. And that's it. It's very simple, it's very quick. So if you wanted to go ahead and again press audio, this time render it out as an MP3, mix down, and then see which one works for you. Very simple way to simulate audio movement. So hopefully you find this tutorial helpful. If you did, be sure to give this a like. As always, thanks for watching, and see you next time.